Hello guys, KP Shamino here with another guide, and it's a guide for this fish, the Trophy Chinook Salmon. I never made for this fish a video before, so I was thinking let's make a tutorial how you need to catch it. So it was not that complicated, it didn't took that long because this is the second one that I got. I think I was here like 5-6 days. I fished outside the time frames too, maybe to discover some other trophy time frames, but I didn't discover other trophy time frames. So it was not that hard to get this fish. So I got two fish, two trophies, one with shiners and one with large minnows. If you want to watch the entire fight with the large minnows, it's after this video or at the end of this video. You guys can check it out. It's only 1 minute 30 seconds. So I'm going to show you guys how you need to catch it. So I'm going to start as always with the positions. So the salmon position or the Chinook salmon position, one of them, because you got like a couple of them here in California, is at the dam. So you need to go to the dam. Let's go to the dam. Then you go all the way with the rocks. So you got a couple of positions here. You got a position here with salmon, but the main problem is that you got steelhead over there too. Then you got here a position at the rocks, and then you got here a position too. It's around those rocks. So I'm getting my trophies over here, but you can get a trophy over here too. I guess probably that you can get a trophy over here too, if you are very patient, because the main problem is you are going to get steelhead too if you go with the bobber and with the bait for the salmon. So I'm fishing for the trophy over here or over here. So what you need to do is, so you got rocks over here and you just need to throw here. And for the guys that saw my first video about the Chinook salmon, it's just the same. So you got a dam here and the flow of the water is pushing your bobber away. So what you need to do is just start at the left. Oh, and that's already a bite. Oh, it goes fast. It's RNG luck for the video. So let's wait a little bit what we get here. Because my hook is a little bit big. So I got a lot of... how do you say it? False bites, I call them. I think it's smallmouth bass too. So they can swallow this hook, but it's a lot harder than the 4-0 hook. And I think, yeah, I think it's a salmon. Yeah. So RNG in the video, or is it a smallmouth? No, it looks like... no, I think it's a salmon, but not a big one. Because I hear the clicking of my reel, so... Yeah, a 7 kilogram. So you need to stand all the way here at the end of the rocks. Then you throw all the way over here, what I just did. You guys saw it. So here is like a construction under the water. So that's a snag point. That's 22 meters. So you need to be behind it. So 23 meters until 27 to 28 meters. That's the sweet zone. You can just put your bobber over here and let the water do the rest. And if you do... if you come over here with your bobber, you just reel in again and you go again. So at the moment my depth is 100 centimeters. So that works perfect for me. I got like these two trophies. If you want to go to the other spot, this is a good spot too. So here is Chinook area too. But you need to do one thingy. So lower your depth to 40 to 50 centimeters. It's not that deep here. The construction goes under the water too. So you can get them here too. It's like, what I do is like this. So I throw like this. Otherwise I do a fail cast. You guys know that. So you always need to throw a little bit further. Then I reel in. And it's almost the same meters that you need to be. So 24, 25. That's more than enough. And then you need to wait. So now it's really good with the snagging. But most of the time if I go to here, I go a little bit less deep than... on the other spot. And I think I got a bite again. Is it once again RNG? Yeah, let's wait a little. It will be really it will be really funny that I get like no, don't say it's no. I thought for a brief moment it was maybe the trophy, but I don't think so. So that's really good RNG. Left spot I got a salmon, and now I got a salmon too. So That's how you need to do it, guys. And it seems that 100 centimeters works on this spot too, so you can go 100 centimeters. I go always a little bit less deep, I thought, because there is a really hard snag somewhere. But if 100 centimeters works, yeah, just use it, guys. So, two spots. Time to show you guys my setup. But first, I'm going to say the time frames. So, the time frames are on a sunny day between 7 and 8 a.m. That's the time frame everybody already know. Then on a partly cloudy day between 8 and 9 p.m. I fished on a cloudy day, but I don't saw a lot of action. I know there was a guy that said, I think on the forums and in the spreadsheet, the Uber spreadsheet, there is between 5 and 6 a.m. in the morning too. But the activity was so low for me that I'm not sure it's really trophy time. So I'm just going to say the time that I got a trophy. That's a sunny one, and that's the partly cloudy one. So that's the one that I'm 100% sure of. I got in each of those time frames one trophy. So it works for me. Okay, so let's go with the setup. So the setup is a very heavy float setup, of course. So the Brutus 360 again, the Espira Double Punch 6500. I'm going with the fluoro 0.45 mm. I'm using the pearl shaped floater, and then I'm using the hook 6.0. Why I'm using the hook 6.0? I started with the 4.0 hook, but I had a lot of smallmouth bass. So, and that's really strange in this game, because sometimes I don't understand this game really well. Is it a bug? Is it like not good? Mats or something. But then I went with the 8.0 hook and I got a smallmouth bass, but I didn't get a Chinook. So I was thinking, how is that even possible? It's smallmouth bass, you know, smallmouth. So then I went with the 6.0 hook and I don't get a lot of smallmouth, but I get Chinook. So yeah, I'm not smart enough to understand that. So a bigger hook gives smallmouth bass, a lower hook gives more Chinook, but less smallmouth bass. So the 6.0 works, that's the only thing that I can say. How it comes that we got so much variation in that bite pattern, I don't know, but I think it's a bug. Simple. So go with the 6.0 hook. It works really well. You get a lot of normal Chinooks too, but you get a lot of trophies too. I always try to work with the highest hook that I can use. I went with the 9.0 hook and the 8.0 hook, but I had so many bites. It's possible it's only trophies that you can get, but you don't catch a lot of trophies. That's very hard to test. But the 6.0 and you will be perfectly okay. I'm going with the shiners. Large minnows works really well too. I think that large minnows work even better than shiners, because with large minnows I had the first day right away a trophy, and with shiners I did 4 to 5 in-game days. So if you can buy them and you got enough gold to buy them, go with the large minnows. I think they are a little bit, not a little bit, I think they are a lot better than the shiners. But it can be RNG too, you never know in this game. But depending on the bite pattern, on the trophy, I would go with the large minnows. So that's it. Then the depth. I already said it, but this is still a bug too. So it's 100 centimeters. You can use it. You guys saw it. I always fished a little bit less deep, but 100 left, 100 right. It works because I just proved it in the video. So that's the setup, guys. Works really well. Then let's have a look to end this video what you can get in one fishing day. So I got like 5 normal Chinooks, and then I got a trophy Chinook salmon. It gives a lot of experience. So this is without premium, and they give a nice amount of money too. You guys can see I got only 7 fish in my net, and I got almost 500 currency. So the Chinook gives a lot of currency to the kilogram. So that was it for the video, guys. Thanks for watching. I'm now going to Michigan because I'm going to make a video about how to catch the trophy muskie with a bobber. Because I remember somewhere a couple of months ago somebody asked it on my YouTube channel to make a video about it. It can take some time sometime, guys, but yeah, if it jumps in my head, I most of the time go invest it and try to make a video for you guys. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, give me a like. If you like my channel, subscribe please. And I see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.